Hi friends, this is Mandeep. Now we are going to see some basic form elements. Already we know about label and test box. Okay, I will skip those things. Okay, already you know the test box. Okay, next one is here we have input type is test box and the name. Next one is password. Input type is text. Okay, sorry, I will use input type is password. Now I will check the output once. Right click, open in new browser. Here if you observe, the alignment of the content is not perfect. Am I right? Okay, I want one after another. Then what I will do, I will use a break, br. Now check the output. If you observe, the element of the name and password, the test boxes are not adjusted properly. That's why only I want to keep those things in the table. Already we know table. Am I right? In that table, in the first row tr, I am going to create two columns. In the first column I will keep this name, and next in the second column I am going to keep this text box in the first row. First row is done, and in the second row, in the first column, I am going to keep password, and in the second column, I am going to keep this password box. I think now you understand how it is aligned. Just refresh the web page. Here now the element of the content is adjusted properly. That's why only better to keep those things in the table. Okay, like that. And the next one is test box. Here in password box, always will display the content line with the dots. It is hiding the data to provide security to the password. And in the next row, in the first column, here I am writing address, and in the second column I am going to write text area. Here for any tag, okay, here for those input elements, form elements, closing is not matter. Here it doesn't have closing. If you want, here you can write like that, it's not mandatory. But if you don't close this text area, you can see how it will affect on the web page. Here you can see it is displaying the whole code which is in the text area, which is after the opened text area. That's why only it is mandatory to close the text area. Now you cannot see that one. That's it. That is test area. And for this test area, we have number of options. We can use number of attributes. The first one is rows. I am giving the rows is 5. Now refresh. It is increased. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 rows are there. And number of columns, I am giving calls is 20. Now refresh. 1 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 0. That means 20 columns. Here if you want, you can increase. I want to make it 22. Now save it and then refresh. 21 is enough. like that. We can adjust. That is your wish. And this is the minimum height and minimum width. And if you want, you can drag it and you can change. That is the option we have only to the text box, sorry, text area. And in the next row, I am going to write gender. In the second column, in the first column we have gender, and in the second column I want to display radio buttons. Input type is radio. Input type is radio. Here, whenever you write input type is radio, what will appear on the web page? A small radio button will appear on the web page. Beside that radio button, I want to write the gender, that is male. Okay, now refresh. Beside that one, you will get radio button. Input element, next one is radio. Again, you will get second radio button. After that, to display, I'm writing female. Refresh. Male, female, like that you are getting. Just observe, when I click on the male, it is selected. Now when I click on the female, now both are selected. I want to select only the single one. Is it possible? Yes, it is possible by using the attribute name. Okay, we have to group these two radio buttons. How to group these two radio buttons? By using the name attribute we can use. I am giving, in the name I am writing gender, gender. Instead of gender, you can write, use the same attribute and same value in the second radio button also. Now in the gender we have two things, one is male and the second one is female. Now you can select only one. You can't select more than one in the radio buttons. That is radio button. Whenever you want to select the single one, then you are going to use radio buttons. If you want to select more than one, at that situation we are going to use checkboxes. For example, in the second row, first column, here I am writing languages, and in the second column I want to display Telugu, Hindi, English. Here we can select more than one. If we use radio button, it will not work properly. It is wrong method. Actually, this is wrong method. Okay, better to use checkbox. Whenever you want to select more than one, then better to use checkbox. That is, input type is checkbox. What you will get? You will get a checkbox. Beside the checkbox, again I want to display the language, that is the Telugu. By default, nothing is selected here. In the mail, I am writing select. It is selected. Sorry. See, checked is checked. Whenever you write, by default it will make mail as checked. It is checked now. By default, whenever you open the web page, by default mail is selected. Like that only you can keep, you can make default things even in the checkboxes also. Input checkbox Telugu, and next one is Hindi. English. English. Now refresh the web page. Oh, spelling, sorry. Checkbox. checkbox. Yes. By default, I want to make Telugu as checked. That's why I am using the attribute checked is checked. Now just refresh. By default, whenever you open the web page, automatically right click, open in browser. By default, here the selected elements is male and Telugu. Yes, here it is. Like that, it will appear. And in the next row, here I am writing city. In that city, I am using select. By default, here you will get a drop down list whenever you are using select box. Okay, in the select box, I am going to use option that is city is Hyderabad. Now just refresh the web page. By default, Hyderabad will appear right here, and the next option is Vijayawada. Like that, we can write number of options: Hyderabad, Vijayawada, Amravati, Delhi. Here we have three options. By default, nothing will appear on the web page. Now in the first option, you don't have anything. Now refresh the web page. Here you don't have anything. Like that, we can write forms. In the next box, next tr, in the first TD, input type is submit. And in the second TD, input type is reset. Here you will get like that. This is the small basic form. Thank you, friends.